Good Thursday morning to you. It's so great to see you today. Hope that you and your family are doing well. Why is it, as human beings, so often we want what we know we can't have? And why is it, as humans, that so often we are not grateful really for something until it's no longer around? Whenever we lose something, then we're like, oh my goodness, I didn't realize what I had. But we're human, and so often that is the case. We have some kin people in Lake Charles that were without power, electrical power, for 27 days. That's a long time to be camping out in Lake Charles in the humidity, heat and humidity, not being able to have any power. I think they may have had a generator, but hey, that's nothing in comparison to having real electricity, if you know what I mean. 27 days. So I know today, they just got it a couple of days ago, the power back on at their house. And I know today they're so grateful and they so appreciate electrical power. And they appreciate the air conditioner because it comes along with it as well. Bless their hearts. And there's still people in Lake Charles that are waiting for the electrical power to come back on at their house. And the crews are there scrambling, trying to get everything rebuilt and the power back on and the people back with electricity in their homes. Wow. I know today there's a bunch of grateful folks in Lake Charles that have the power back on. I want to be a grateful person. I want to be a grateful person. And then also I want to be that person that realizes there are some things I can't have. Sometimes you got to tell your flesh, no, you can't have that. It's not for you. It's not good for you. Because you know what? We don't get everything that we want. We don't get everything we want. And also this road that we're living, this road we're walking on, the life we live, it's not always a bed of roses. And that's just the way it is. Life is the way it is sometimes. But I am so happy to know that the Lord is walking beside us. And He's our comfort. He's our strength. He's our wisdom. He's our direction. I mentioned it last night in church during the message. And that is this. If you are truly following God's Spirit and His Spirit is leading you, today, wherever you are, know that you're in the perfect will of God. If God, His Spirit, has led you to where you are, know today that you're in the perfect will of God. Things may not be perfect in according to your flesh, according to your thinking, but still, you can rest in the knowledge that you're where you're supposed to be. God bless you. Have a great Thursday. I appreciate you watching Coffee with the Pastor.